Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Well, I want to address a question today sent in by Pablo. And boy, this is a great question from Pablo. I wonder why Microsoft never thought of this bit of functionality. Pablo says, you know, if you select some numeric cells in the spreadsheet, you can look down here in the status bar and see the total of those cells, 81074. He says, why can't I press a keystroke and copy that total to the clipboard? And then I could come over to another cell and paste that total. And I said, wow, that's a great idea. Now, there's no way that I know of in Excel to do that, but we can do that using just a tiny bit of macro code. So let's go into the Office button, Excel Options, Show Developer tab in the ribbon, click OK, and now we can go to the Developer tab and go over to Visual Basic. I want to show you the two bits of code that I wrote here. Macro 1, this is like the copy macro. So last sum, that's a variable, is equal to application.worksheetfunction.sum selection.value. And then the second macro is activeCell.value is equal to last sum. Now, in order to make VBA remember this number between the two macros, we have to have this global declaration at the top, global last sum as long. That says, hey, this variable is going to live even after this macro finishes. That's very unusual. Most of the time, variables, you know, they go away as soon as the macro finishes. Now, to make this be a little bit better, I came here to the macros dialog, and for macro 1, I went to options and said, okay, we're going to make this be control shift C. Usually control C is copy. I assign this to control shift C, and then for macro 2, the paste macro options, we go to control shift V. So, let's try it. We'll select some cells. I'll do control shift C and then go to a new cell and do control shift V, and it pastes the total of the original cells. Great bit of functionality. Microsoft, you should add this to Excel 2012 or whatever the next one's going to be after Excel 2010. But in the meantime, just a couple of tiny little macros there, one line each, as well as a global declaration, will solve this problem. Now, what would have been really, really cool, and I couldn't figure out how to do it, in the status bar, it's possible to change that sum to something else. You can change it to an average or whatever. You can right-click and show an average instead of the sum. Actually, in 2007, you can show them all, average count, numerical count, min and max. I would have loved to have been able to figure out which one was down there and done the appropriate function in the first macro, but it doesn't seem that Microsoft lets us know what the status bar is showing. They'll tell us what message is down here in the left side of the status bar, but not which quick sum feature is down there. That's too bad. If Pablo wanted to do averages, or if you want to do averages, you could always have a couple of different macros, one that does sum, one that does average, and so on. So there you have it. Great question from Pablo, and just a couple of lines of macro code to help solve it. I want to thank you for watching. We'll see you next time for another Netcast for Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.